Hey everybody, we're Ron Dyke here, and today we're going to review an old but still gold iPhone 4 and see if it is still worth it. So without further ado, let's get started. If you want to see app reviews, tech reviews and many other kind of technology videos, make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon. So let's first talk about the design. The design is very outdated, seeing as you have 18:9 aspect ratio displays, you have those bezel-less displays. If you compare a very old flagship with the new devices, you're going to feel the outdatedness. You have the glass back, which feels premium than the next model, which was the iPhone 5. So iPhone 4 is a combination of glass and metal build. It looks premium still now. On the left side, you have a mute switch, where you can customize the switch. You have the volume rockers, which are separate round buttons in this case. On the bottom of the phone, you have an old styled port for charging and connectivity. You have dual speakers now. The speakers are not that much loud, but you can still work with this phone. And if you want to listen to music, you can just use the headphone jack, which this phone has. So on the top, you have a power button and headphone jack. Now let's talk about the software and the things that matter. Now it runs on iOS 7.1.2. It is halfway outdated in 2018, but it does not mean that you cannot use all of the app. You can still use majority of the app. You can use YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp. And if you cannot use a particular app, you can install an older version for the app. So you can basically use the majority of the apps, which are more than enough for me and my daily usage. The software is still fluid in 2018. You don't see much hiccup. You can see the specs on the screen at the moment. Let's talk about the gaming performance. You can still play games. You can still play light games and some heavy games as well. You can still play some heavy games which are not very new. You can still play most of the games, just not very graphically intensive games. I have played a couple of 3D games which are exceeding about the 500 MB mark, and they were played pretty well on this phone. So I'm pretty impressed that a phone this old can still run games like that. And let's talk about the camera. You have a pretty basic 5 megapixel camera. You have your basic cameras. I mean, they're not very much impressive, but you can still click some casual photos for your social media. And now I'm going to put some photo samples you can see on the video screen right now, so you can judge by yourself how the photo quality is. So in conclusion, this phone is still a great phone, and if you can get it for $40, I mean, you do not get very much good phones in this price range if you want to get a new phone these days. So it's still a great phone for this cheap. So that is it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon so you don't never miss any upload. Now have a nice day, and I will see you in the next video. Peace. This is a homage beat.